Okay, so again, I have both of these books on my shelf, but if you happen, just happen to be the teacher who's just starting out, and maybe you're lucky enough to have a young student, or even an older student that's just starting out and learning the Nemeth code, this might be just the book for you. And it's called Learning the Nemeth Braille Code, and notice we call this the blue book, and this particular one does have that binder, but you can also, if you may have this already in a hard copy, the older versions were in hard copy, and it's Learning the Nemeth Braille Code. Now notice the title, part of the title, A Manual for Teachers and Students. And Ruth, this was developed by Ruth Craig, who I'm sorry to say she's no longer with us, but she wrote us a fantastic book. And again, this was just to plug the Braille Authority of North America. This was adopted by them and is available again from the American Printing House for the Blind. It's available in one volume in Braille or in this print volume. And again, on federal quota monies from American Printing House for the Blind. Now, if you open it up, it kind of looks like the rest of them. Doesn't look too terribly different. And as you're going through, I think you might notice that it's a little more user-friendly. There's a little more explanation here in addition to the problems. And if you come along here, let me see, that's just some, what, oh, here they are. I'm looking for some of these. If you jump in here, practice exercises. And then it goes on and it actually gives some exercises. But guess what's nice about this book? If you go to the back of the book, it has answers in the back of the book, which all of us teachers, I know, we always kind of worry about whether the student's going to find those. But there is the answer. This is the answer section. So again, you have all of the answers for all of those practice exercises. So you're able to check yourself. And I like the fact that it's in the back of the book. It makes you try it, but then you look on your own, you look in the back of the book to check and see if you've done everything correctly. Now, if you look on the index, it even looks a little different. It's a little larger for one thing, but let's look for that exponent this time. And I'm only picking on this just because it's something that so many people do look for. Okay, and there it is, exponents. 71 and 74. But let's suppose I've gotten so used to that word superscript that I want, that's what I think of first. Okay, let's look over here and let's see where we are. Oops, I'm looking. There we go. Okay, if we look right here, superscript 71 to 74. Punctuation indicator following, 72 contractions in, 74. So again, either whether you're the exponents person or the superscripts person, you're going to be able to find it in this index. So much more user-friendly. So again, this book is so much more user-friendly. It has the answers in the back of the book, has more of a little teaching explanation, what we teacher types are really looking for. However, you're going to notice that it is much thinner, okay, look in comparison, much thinner than the green book, okay, and we're looking at binder, but let me just tell you, this, as I said, it only comes in one volume in Braille, so this book is much smaller. So what's the problem with this book? Everything I love, that always has some problem to it. And the problem with this is it will get you, I used to say it will get you up to about eighth grade, probably not that far anymore, maybe middle school. And I say that because now we're already taking Algebra 1 in the eighth grade and pre-algebra even before that. And therefore you're going to need if you have a student or you yourself are beyond let's say sixth or seventh grade mathematics, if you are starting in algebra, this book is not going to get you very far. You will definitely need the green book. So just keep that in mind. I several times have come across teachers who said this is the perfect book for them though, because they have a young student who is a Braille user just starting out, and they said this gives me a chance to teach myself and then to teach the student. And I'm wholeheartedly in agreement with that. That makes it more meaningful for you and the student as well, if you happen to be that lucky. Now, I will tell you, when I started out, I had students already in high school, so I'm afraid I had to go directly to the Green Book to get all the information I needed. But again, if you have that student who's just beginning to learn Nemeth Braille code and you're just in about the same spot, this would be an ideal book, I think, for you. But again, all three books, the blue, the yellow, well, it changes color, and the Green Book are all available from the American Printing House for the Blind, and they are on federal quota monies, and I would really strongly urge you to get the books that you need and learn how to Braille and read the Nemeth code.